Who's there?
Who's there?
Who's there?
No, that's not quite right. Let's try something else.
Who's there?
No, let's try a little bit more mechanical.
Who's there?
Let's try now with a bit more force, a bit more anxiety.
Who's there?
Yes, that's the voice.
Great, he's with us. Hi, Baxter. All right, everybody, let's make a start. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
When you're ready.
Yeah. I'm good to walk in.
Yeah.
Okay. Good Hamlet, cast thy knighted colour off, and let thine eye look like a friend on Denmark. Do not forever with thy veiled lids seek thy noble father in the dust. Thou knowest 'tis common that all that lives must die. Passing through nature to eternity.
Okay, that's lovely. Keep that kind of expression. Could you now, when we get to and let thine eye look like a friend on Denmark, could you take Mitch's, the king's hand, at that point, all right? Because he's Denmark. So just perhaps reach back.
Shall I bring
and grasp, and then bring, yes. All right,
yeah.
We want to give the sense of the unity of the two of you in opposition with Hamlet, all right? Okay. Let's go.
Good Hamlet, cast thy knighted colour off and let thine eye look like a friend on Denmark. Do not forever with thy veiled lids seek thy noble father in the dust. Thou knowest 'tis common that all that lives must die. Passing through nature to eternity.
Aye, madam, it is common.
No, Hamlet, Baxter, a little bit more, I think a bit more assertive there with your mother, all right? So could you say that line again? All right?
Do you want us to go from back here, yeah?
No, we'll just go from where Hamlet repeats that line, all right? Okay.
Aye, madam, it is common.
If it be, why seems it so particular with thee?
Seems, madam. Nay, it is. I know not seems.
Good. That's good. Thank you.
Remember thee. Yea, from the table of my memory, I'll wipe away all trivial fond records, all sores of books, all forms, all pressures past, that youth and observation copied there, and thy commandment all alone shall live within the book and volume of my brain.
So this time, instead of a full bow as you were doing before, let's just try a little bit more informal, so just a head nod as the opening bow, all right? Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Something have you heard of Hamlet's transformation. So call it,
Sith nor the exterior nor the inward man resembles that it was.
Good.
Yeah.
Good.
Am I going to be reading it out while I'm doing my care?
No, you're not reading it out.
Oh, I'm not reading it. I'm like...
You're reading it.
Okay, in my head.
Yeah. Okay, and action.
Doubt thou the stars are fire. Doubt that the sun doth move. Doubt truth to be a liar. But never doubt I love. Thine evermore, most dear lady, whilst this machine is to him, Hamlet. What piece of work is a man? How noble in reason! How infinite in faculties, in form and moving! How express and admirable in action! How like an angel in apprehension! How like a god! The beauty of the world, the paragon of animals! And yet to me, what is this quintessence of dust? Man delights, not me.
The actors are come hither, my lord. They're the best actors in the world.
We'll have a speech straight. Come, give us a taste of your quality. Come, a passionate speech.
What speech, my good lord?
I heard thee speak me a speech once. The rugged Pyrrhus, he whose sable arms, black as his purpose, did the knight resemble.
Unequal match. Pyrrhus at Priam drives.
Hold on, hold on. I think actually, I think both of you, I'm looking for a little bit more drama, Shakespearean drama, with the delivery of those lines.
Sure.
So let's go, we'll go back to Hamlet's lines. So Baxter, if we could go back to the rugged Pyrrhus, all right? A little bit more heightened drama, please. Okay, go.
I heard thee speak me a speech once, the rugged Pyrrhus. He whose sable arms, black as his purpose, did the knight resemble.
Unequal matched, Pyrrhus a Priam drives, his rage strikes wide. But with the width and wind of his fierce sword, the nerved father falls. Unequal
oh, what a rogue and peasant slave am I. Is it not monstrous that this player here, but in a fiction, in a dream of passion, could force his soul so to his own
his
conceit.
His rage strikes wide, but with the whiff and wind of his fierce sword, the nerved father falls.
Okay, that was, I like that. How did it,
That skull had a tongue in it and could sing once. Alas, poor Yorick, I knew him, Horatio, a fellow of infinite jest, of most excellent fancy. To what base uses we may return, Horatio? Why may not imagination trace the noble dust of Alexander till a find it stopping a bunghole? To be or not to be, that is the question. To die, to sleep, no more. To die, to sleep. To sleep, perchance to dream, eh? There's the rub, for in that sleep of death, what dreams may come, when we have shuffled off this mortal coil, must give us pause.
Thank you.